you mentioned you shot in New York, and I imagine it's pretty fun because obviously in this city, everybody, life is going around all around the set. Did people notice you were shooting? Were they excited?
Well, New Yorkers are very special. We shot a couple places, and the fans in Harlem, where we shot a lot, were very supportive. And we would be shooting, and things would be going well, scenes going well, and you want to get the shot because you never know when something's going to technically go wrong. You have to shoot it again because we do multiple takes. People would walk by, and they'd notice, you know, me, Luke Cage! And I'm like, we start the scene again, and it's like, Luke Cage! Trying to shoot a scene here. Luke Cage! I'm like, okay. Sorry. I mean, we're trying to shoot. It would go on and on.
But New Yorkers don't care.
They don't care. Boom boxes.
Yeah.
They would take boom boxes and walk on set knowing that we're shooting, and then the cops would come and try and get them, and then it would become a game, and they would chase them around.
That's fantastic.
And they'd chase them around in circles, and it's like, oh, God. I mean, they want their 15 minutes.
They want their 15 minutes. They and you can say we're trying to shoot something, and they're saying, I'm trying to say hello to a fictional character.
Exactly.
So I guess we're at loggerheads.
I bought the comic book. I want my time.
I want my time.
I want my time.
Obviously, a physical show, and you, but your character who is impervious to bullets, but you do not kill your enemies.
No, no.
A lot of throwing them around, a lot of beating them up.
Yeah, we have what we call a technique called smack foo.
Smack foo.
Smack foo. Yes, that's something that James Liu, our stunt coordinator, came up with. Basically, it's like, you know, smacking people around, you know, like it's kind of like pimp slapping, like, you know, like a biatch slap.
Gotcha.
So what
that's
we do,
your superpower.
Yeah, it's like you come near me, I just disrespect you, like bam, smack you across your face.
Is it always back of the hand?
Always back of the hand.
Okay.
Front of the hand sometimes depending. I'll do a double, you know,
yeah,
it's like a
gotcha.
Double thing.
That's the B and
yeah,
then the
Och. Yeah, the B and the Och.
Yeah.
B and the Och.
Yeah.
B, yeah. Yeah, that's it.
And so that, I see, again, you're probably pretty good now at not actually hitting the people you're working with.
I'm pretty good. I smacked one guy, but he had it coming.
Gotcha.
He had it coming. That was something I owed him from lunchtime.
Okay, yeah, gotcha. Yeah. And then they can't put it on you. You can just say you missed.
I'm sorry. I just mismeasured and you got, yeah. You know, and I'm the star, so yeah. I mean, they're like, what are they gonna do?
Right, exactly. You know? I think what people were really drawn to with Daredevil, with Jessica Jones, and obviously we live in this era of so many superhero movies, but they have so much less time. With these 13-episode shows, you actually get to get way more into the character than you would in the movies. And is that another thing that sort of drew you to doing a project like this?
Well, the thing about this, I mean, we have 2.5 hours in films. In this, we have 13 episodes. In the first episode, you don't have to get to know everything there is to know about Luke Cage. You can get to know just, like, what his first day is like. How does he get up every morning and just kind of go about his day? And that's when, as an actor, you want to take your time and peel back the layers. The writing is great. The character study is great. And this is not about special effects so much as it is about a character study, about a person who is like you and I, or, well, I am him, but excuse me. Like you guys, who is weird. I'm like, yeah, I am him. Okay. So, but it's like the person next door who actually has the same problems you have, and he's trying to get through the day, but he also has super abilities. So they don't really enhance his life so much as they create problems, so he has to figure a way to incorporate them into his life. That's kind of how...
Well, that's great. Well, based on the first episode I saw, you guys are off to a great start.
Well, I appreciate
now, what... obviously, you look like this now. What were you a cool dude in high school? Was this a thing?
You know, I was a loner of sorts. I kind of stayed to myself. I mean, I did have friends. I wasn't like, you know, some geek that stayed in the room and just played by himself.
I don't know. Loner sounds like a
geek. All right. Well, here's the thing. you pegged me out in one minute. He's got me.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I was, you know, I kind of, you know, I did the best I could. I mean, I had friends. But I was voted most ambitious, actually, when I graduated.
Really?
Which is good.
I guess it's nice, right?
It is, but here's the thing. I had most ambitious, but I should have had another accolade. And I'm not blowing my own horn, but I was this close to being most attractive in my senior class.
There you go. It's okay.
No,
don't be ambitious about this.
I am being ambitious about it.
Okay. This is so like you.
No, I know. See, I have to have it.
So what happened? Was there just a better looking guy?
No, it was called, he was my cousin. And I found out after the fact, because he went around, he paid people. I'm not kidding. He walked around paying people to vote for him. And our senior class was like 100 people. So to basically get the deciding vote, he handed like maybe 50 bucks out, which was a lot of money for him, but he wanted to get that award.
I hope he also won Most Likely to Succeed, because that guy...
No. That's me, most ambitious. That's the same. It's the same. It's one and the same.
There you go. Yeah. There you go. He voted most industrious.
Yeah.
Most likely to rig an election
in the future. Most likely to rig an election. He's doing hard time now.
He's doing hard time.